enemies, you are desperate in the need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned that in the Holy Quran. Allah says what? The mother of Nabi Musa alayhi salam, when she lost the baby Musa, Allah says, and indeed the heart of the mother of Musa alayhi salam became empty of everything else but death. If you are in that condition where everything is removed from your heart at that moment, except to turn to Allah, then also in that condition your dua must be answered. We come back and we read advice from Mawlana Shaykh Ibrahim radiallahu
anhu.
He says,
وَلَا بُدَّ لِمَنْ يُرِيدُ الْإِنْتِفَاعَ أَنْ يَحْفَظَ مَا يَذْكُرُ مِنَّا نَظْمًا وَنَفْرًا.
Because Shaykh Ibrahim said, and it is necessary for whoever wants to benefit from me to memorize my writings and my words, whether they are the poems or whether they are the letters that are right. That is therefore we want to read one of the letters of Shaykh Ibrahim. Because we are in need of benefit.
الرسالة الثامنة والعشرون من الوصايا.
The 28th letter from the advices of Sheikh Ibrahim رضي الله عنه.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah.
وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما.
صلوات and salam on the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and his family and his companions.
وعلى الحمد لله الواحد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
All praise be to Allah, the one and only, who has no partners.
والصلاة والسلام على الفاتح الخاتم.
And salutations and greeting on the opener and the closer.
سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Our master Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ورضي الله عن مدد الكائنات.
And may Allah be pleased with the madad of this universe.
والعوالم العينية والغيبية.
And all the worlds in it.
سيدنا أحمد.
Our master Ahmad رضي الله عنه.
أما بعد.
After that.
سلام سليم لا لغو فيه ولا تاثيم.
I greet you a pure greeting.
يا أخينا وحبيبنا المفسد علي جاسي.
I greet my brother and our beloved one علي جاسي.
وفقنا الله وإياه لما يحب ويرضى.
May Allah guide him and us to what is good for us.
وداوى بمنه قلوبنا المرضى.
May Allah cure through his grace our sick hearts.
وارزقنا وإياه عافية الدارين.
And may Allah grant you and us contentment in both worlds.
وسعادة الدارين.
And happiness of both worlds.
إليه الإعلام.
After that, I wish to inform you.
لأني قد أتاني كتابك الكريم.
I have received your letter.
ووقفت على خطابك السليم.
And I read its contents and what you wrote to me.
وفرحت بوصول كتابكم.
And I was very happy to read your letter.
فرحاً.
A happiness.
توجهت به همتنا إليكم.
It's a happiness that made me turn my barakah towards you.
وقد جددت لك الورد اللازم.
Therefore I have renewed for you the ورد اللازم of this طريقة التجانية.
والوظيفة المعلومة.
And I have renewed for you the وظيفة.
وذكر يوم الجمعة.
And I have renewed for you the إجازة of the ذكر الجمعة.
بالإذن الخاص.
With the special permission
من الشيخ رضي الله عنه.
From the Sheikh Ahmad Tijani رضي الله عنه.
وهنيئا لك.
So congratulations to you.
لقد نعم هذا أعلق أنا وأقول هذا أهمية الاتصال المريد بشيخه.
Sheikh Bai says, I comment on what we read from the letter. I explain and say that this shows the importance of the attachment, the communication between the murid to his sheikh.
لأن في ذاك الزمن الذي أرسل هذا الأخ هذا المريد الرسالة ليس هناك هواتف ولا ليس هناك جوالات ولا هناك شيء.
In those days in which this brother he wrote the letter to Sheikh Ibrahim, there were no phones or anything.
ولا هذا الزمن ينوب عنه الاتصالات الموجودة.
In these days one can even make a phone call or speak on the phone.
على كل حال الشيخ إبراهيم قال.
In any case Sheikh Ibrahim said.
لما وقف على الرسالة.
When he read the letter of his brother.
هذا معناه أيضا لما حصل الاتصال.
When the connection took place between the murid and the sheikh, And the letter came from the murid to the sheikh.
توجهت به همة فناء إليه.
Sheikh Ibrahim said, indeed your letter made me so happy that it made me turn my power and my mother towards you. How did that happen? Because he got the letter from this murid.
ببركة هذه الرسالة تحركت همة الشيخ.
Through the barakah of this letter that this talibi wrote to Sheikh Ibrahim, it moved the barakah of the sheikh towards him and the attention of the sheikh towards him.
بذلك تلك الهمة يمكن أن يصلح الله به كل شيء.
That himma, that attention of your sheikh, that can fix everything in your life.
أكثر مما يصلح كثرة الأذكار والأوراد. تلك همة الشيخ.
That can fix everything in your life, even more than making a lot of zikrs and a lot of prayers. Just if the attention, the special attention, the himma of your sheikh is turned towards you, that is even more powerful and a greater blessing than all the zikrs you can make.
لأن هذا ما من الله إليك والذكر والصلاة ما منك إلى الله هل هي مقبولة أم لا في مشكلة.
Because the zikrs that you make, it is from you to Allah. You don't know if they are accepted or not. But when the himma, the attention of the sheikh is towards you, that is from Allah to you. That is
better.
That is for sure accepted because it is coming from the sheikh towards you. And because of the barakah of this communication that takes place then,
this عن أول وظيفة وذكر الجمعة بالإذن الخاص ليس إذن عام بالإذن الخاص من الشيخ رضي الله عنه.
And through the barakah of this letter that this talibi wrote to the sheikh, the second blessing that he got was that the sheikh, he was so happy that he renewed the tariqah for this brother, and he renewed it not with the normal permission that you give, but he said, I renew it with a special permission from Sheikh Ahmad Tijani رضي الله عنه himself, from me, from Sheikh Ahmad Tijani directly. It is a special renewal.
من حي عن حي.
Sheikh Ibrahim then says, Sheikh Ibrahim, Sheikh Bai says, from an alive one, from an alive one. An alive one from an alive one. That's why Sheikh Ibrahim immediately after that said, so congratulations to you.
قال شيخنا رضي الله عنه.
Because our Sheikh Ahmad Tijani رضي الله عنه said,
أن وضعنا عليه طابعا انتهينا منه. معنى ذلك من وضعنا عليه طابعنا انتهينا منه.
انتهينا منه. Sheikh Ibrahim then says, Sheikh Ahmad Tijani رضي الله عنه said, our Sheikh Ahmad Tijani رضي الله عنه said, whoever we stamp with our stamp, then we are done with him.
معنى ذلك.
The meaning of that is,
يفسر الشيخ إبراهيم.
Sheikh Ibrahim then explains that statement of Sheikh Ahmad Tijani.
من أخذ عن الورد نال سعادة الدارين من حينه.
The meaning of that statement, Sheikh Ibrahim says, is that whoever takes my wird, Sheikh Ahmad Tijani, another Sheikh Ahmad Tijani is saying, whoever takes my wird, then he is guaranteed the happiness of dunya and akhirah from the moment he takes my wird. And I advise yourself and myself to have the fear of Allah privately and publicly. And I advise you to be busy with Allah, to busy yourself with Allah.
برفض كل ما سواه.
By refusing everything other than him.
وعلم أن ما سواه كسراب بقيعة.
And know that everything other than him is just a mirage, you know, which appears real but is not real.
يحسبه الله ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا.
The thirsty person who is deluded because of his thirst, he thinks that the mirage, the, you know, the fake river is actually there. But when he comes there, he will see it was never there.
واتخذ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وسيلتك العظمى.
And take رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم as your greatest intermediary to Allah and your door to Allah.
بالإكثار من الصلاة عليه.
How? By making a lot of salawat on him صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فإن ذلك هو الطريق لمن يريد الوصول إلى معرفة الله تعالى.
For that is the road to whoever wants to arrive and achieve the معرفة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
وبالأخص.
And especially صلاة الفاتحة لما أغلق.
إنها الكنز الأعظم.
Because it is the greatest treasure.
والسر المطلسم.
And the hidden secret.
وعين المعارف الأقوم.
And it is, you know, the essence of all the معرفة.
فإن لها مراتب ثلاثة.
For the صلاة الفاتحة has three levels of it.
مرتبة ظاهرة.
The level of the ظاهر. مرتبة ظاهرة.
وباطنة.
And the مرتبة الباطنة, the hidden level.
وباطنة الباطنة فيه.
And the hidden, the most hidden level, which is مرتبة الباطنة الباطنة صلاة الفاتح.
مرتبتها الظاهرة تستغرق أعمال جميع أفراد الكائنات من أول العالم إلى آخره.
By reciting the صلاة الفاتح only on its first apparent level, which is the normal level if it is recited, that alone by reciting it normally like that at the مرتبة الظاهرة, that will get you the ثواب of the good deeds of everybody in the whole universe.
من أولها إلى آخرها.
From the beginning of the universe till the end of the universe.
ومرتبتها الباطنة.
As far as the مرتبة الباطنة, the hidden level of صلاة الفاتح.
تستغرق أسرار بطون العالم.
It includes
من أولها إلى آخرها.
One recitation of it with that level, الباطنة, it includes and covers all the hidden realities of the whole universe, the باطن of the whole universe.
ومرتبتها باطنة الباطنة.
And its level of باطنة الباطنة, the most hidden, hidden level of صلاة الفاتح.
السر الأعظم.
Is the greatest secret.
الذي هو غاية الغايات.
Which is the goal of goals.
عليك يا أخي بالإكثار من هذه الصلاة.
Therefore, my brother, I advise you to recite a lot of this salawat, salat al-fatih.
في سائر الأوقات الليلية والنهارية.
Especially in all your times, whether it is day or night, recite salat al-fatih.
وقد نصحتك لله.
And I have advised you for the sake of Allah.
ولازم 500 من صلاة الفاتح لما أغلق.
And I advise you to recite consistently recite 500 of Salatul Fatih
بعد العشاء الأخير قبل النوم.
After Isha before you sleep.
منذ ذلك في وقت السحر.
And the same amount during Tahajjud time.
منذ ذلك بعد ورد الصبح.
And the same amount after you make the ورد of Salatul Fajr.
والكلمة أنك تصلي عليه امتثالا لأمر ربك.
And you should make the niyyah that you are reciting Salawat on the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in obedience to Allah's order for us to do that. Sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. And in honor and respect and love for Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That is your niyyah for reciting the salawat.
حتى لا تقرأه بنية الفتح. تقرأه بنية الامتثال لأمر الله والمحبة والتعظيم.
Sheikh Bai says, even you don't recite it with the niyyah of getting the opening or marif or anything. That shouldn't be part of the niyyah when you recite it.
تقرأه امتثال لأمر ربك.
You simply recite it, salawat, in obedience to Allah's order for us to do it when he says sallu alayhi, make salawat
on him.
And the second niyyah is to recite it in honor and love and glorification of Rasulullah ﷺ and for no other reason after that. Like salah that you make every day. You don't make salah so that you can get
jannah.
But when you are making salah, in the salah you can ask Allah for jannah.
بعد ذلك يمكن أن تقضى بعد عقد الصلاة يمكن أن تصل الجنة.
After you have finished with the salah, you can also ask for jannah.
لكن لا تصلي من أجل أن من أجل الجنة.
But you don't start your prayer with the knee of this. I'm doing this so that I can get the jannah.
هذا عبادة التجار الغير الرابحين.
This is the worship of the unsuccessful businessman.
وهكذا الصلاة على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the same is the salawat on Nabi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
تقرأه فقط امتثالا لأمر الله.
You only recite it to obey Allah's command, to recite it. And in honor and respect and love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's why you recite it. After you have recited the salawat with that niyyah, and then if you ask Allah for the opening and the marifah, there's nothing wrong with that. But you don't start your reciting with that niyyah that I'm doing this so that I can get the opening from Allah.
كما أن الله تبارك وتعالى يستحق عبادة لذاته.
Just as Allah deserves his all worship simply for his own self.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يستحق الصلاة عليه لذاته.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم also deserves salawat simply for his own self, for the sake of himself, for no other reason.
فإن المداوم على هذه.
Then Sheikh Ibrahim رضي الله عنه continues says, and whoever consistently recites the salawat in these three times.
بإذن الخاص من أهله.
With the special permission from the people who have the right to give such a permission, he will indeed get the opening, the fatḥ.
لا محالة.
For sure.
بحول الله وقوته.
By the power of Allah.
وهذا المكتوب في هذا الكتاب.
And Sheikh Ibrahim says.
Sheikh Ibrahim says,
and after that.
هذا المكتوب في هذا الكتاب.
And what I have written for you in this letter.
هو ما عندي من الأسرار.
This is all that I have of the secrets.
وحسبي وحسبك.
And that is enough for me and enough for you.
ماذا كتب في هذا الكتاب؟
Sheikh Bai says, what has he written in this letter?
كتب في هذا الكتاب الورد اللازم.
He wrote the ورد اللازم.
ما الوظيفة؟
He said, I renew the وظيفة.
وذكر الجمعة.
And the ذكر الجمعة.
وهذه الأذكار الثلاثة.
And these three ذكر. And then after that he said 500 salat al-fatih.
بعد أن ذكرنا بمراتبه ولا ذكر لنا مراتبه الثلاث.
After he mentioned the three levels of salat al-fatih.
هذه الأذكار الثلاثة 500 salat al-fatih.
And then he mentioned the 500 salat al-fatih in the three different times.
ووصي لنا بالتقوى.
And he advised us to have taqwa and to busy ourselves with Allah and reject all others. If a human being busies himself with this advice of Shaykh, he will gain all the secrets. And if he leaves this, even if he has all the secret prayers and sirrus of the whole world, he has nothing but the devil.
رزقنا الله وإياكم الاشتغال بالله.
May Allah guide us and you to busy ourselves with Him.
رزقنا الله وإياكم التقوى سرا وجهرا.
May Allah grant you and us تقوى privately and publicly.
هذا إذا ذكرنا التقوى سرا وجهرا هذا محيط جميع أوامر الشرع.
If we have تقوى inwardly and outwardly, it covers all the orders of the Sharia.
وإذا رزقنا أيضا ملازمة الورد والوظيفة وذكر الجمعة قمنا بجميع أوامر الطريقة.
And if we practice our ورد and our وظيفة and ذكر الجمعة properly and consistently, then we have covered all the orders of the tariqa. That is what the tariqa orders us. Nothing more.
وإذا قمنا بهذه الأذكار من صلاة الفاتحة في الأوقات الصلاة أيضا قمنا بجميع أوامر صاحب الفرض.
And if we perform the Salat al-Fatih 500 times in these three times, then we have covered all the orders of the Sahib al-Faidah radiallahu
anhu.
Because Sahib al-Faidah came with the Marifa.
وهذا هو المفتاح Salat al-Fatih.
And Salat al-Fatih is the key to that Marifa.
رزقنا الله وإياكم اشتغال بما في هذه الرسالة من الخير.
May Allah grant you and us to be busy with the beautiful advices that were given in this letter of Shaykh Ibrahim. May Allah make you and us from the pious ones and the muhsineen. May Allah make you and us from the knowers of Allah. And protect you and protect us from deprivation after He has provided us. And with the harms of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decisions that He can make against us. And protect us from the celebration of our enemies in harm to us. For the sake of the honor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the advice.
وخلاف النصيحة لنفسي قبلكم.
It is advice to myself before you.
الله يرزقنا العمل.
May Allah guide us to practice on this نصيحة.
ويرزقنا الإخلاص.
And grant us sincerity in that practice.
مضاعف الإخلاص يرزقنا القبول.
And then after sincerity may He grant us acceptance of what we do.
لأن العمل بغير الإخلاص.
Because actions without sincerity.
ما فيش نتيجة.
They have no results.
والعمل مع الإخلاص إذا لم يكن معه القبول من الله أيضا.
And a good deed with sincerity, if it is not accepted by Allah,
ليس فيه نتيجة أيضا.
Then that also has no fayda, no result in it, if Allah has not accepted your good action.
الله يرزقنا العمل.
Therefore, Allah, may Allah grant us good actions.
يرزقنا الإخلاص.
And grant us to be sincere when we do them.
يرزقنا
And then may he grant us acceptance of that after that. That's why the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith, he says, all people are destroyed except the knowledgeable ones, those who know.
والعالمون كلهم هلكا.
And he said all those who know are going to be destroyed.
إلا العالمون.
Except those who practice on what they know.
والعالمون كلهم هلكا.
And all the practitioners are also going to be destroyed.
إلا المخلصون.
Except those who practice sincerely.
والمخلصون على خطر عظيم.
And then the Prophet says, and those who are sincere are also in a very dangerous situation because Allah might accept from them and might still reject them. We never know what is in the plan of Allah, what Allah is planning for us. We have no idea. Even if your action is sincere, we still have no guarantee. We don't know what is Allah's plan for us.
Allah help us.
May Allah help us. That is why our Shaykh Imam Hassan al-Sisi radiallahu anhu, even in the last of his life, what he would always make a lot of dua in the last years of his life. In the last months and years of his life, one dua that Shaykh Ibrahim used to make, Shaykh Hassan used to make a lot is, in all of his gatherings was, may Allah accept from you and us all our good deeds. Because he knew that even good actions, and even if they are sincere good actions, if Allah does not want to accept them, then they are of no use. May Allah grant you enough sincerity. May Allah grant you enough acceptance of our deeds. These big sheikhs, they are the successors. The successors of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Uthman, Sayyidina Ali. All of them. All of them was a knowledgeable person. And all of them used to practice on what they knew. And all of them were sincere in that practice. Nevertheless, they used to fear Allah so much. As Allah says about the Sahaba, and the ones who give what they give, yet their hearts are fearing from the day in which they will return to Allah.
هذا عمر في آخر حياته.
This is Sayyidina Umar رضي الله عنه in the last days of his life.
يسأل عمن طعنه.
He was asking about the man who stabbed him. He was asking the people, this man that stabbed me, as you know, Sayyidina Umar was stabbed. He said, this man who stabbed me, is he a Muslim or is he a non-Muslim? When it was told to Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Umar, the man who stabbed you is a non-Muslim. He was very happy that at least the one who killed him was not a Muslim. Because Sayyidina Umar is fearing that if a Muslim had to kill him, maybe it was for the haqq, you know, maybe the Muslim had a good reason to kill him. So when he heard that the one who stabbed him was a non-Muslim, he said, Alhamdulillah, it was the enemy of Allah that stabbed me and not a Muslim.
وصار أيضا يتوجع على أمره يتوجع على ذنوبه مع هذا العمل مع هذا العمل ومع هذا الإخلاص يتوجع.
And despite being stabbed by a non-Muslim, which would make him, you know, a shaheed, you know, he was still making a lot of dua for his sins and asking Allah forgiveness before he passed away from the stabbing.
العباس قال له أنت نذروك لا يخاف عليه.
سيدنا ابن عباس رضي الله عنه, the cousin of the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he saw سيدنا عمر in the last hours of his life making a lot of asking a lot of tawbah and asking Allah forgiveness, he said, oh Umar, somebody in your position does not need to worry so much about what will happen to him in the akhirah. Rasulullah passed away and he was happy with you, he was satisfied with you, Umar, and Rasulullah guaranteed Jannah for you, Umar.
وأنت كنت خليفة المسلمين.
And you were the Khalifa, the Amir of all the Muslims, the leader of all the Muslims.
فتحت البلاد.
And you conquered the land for Islam.
وفعلت وفعلت.
And you did this and you did that, and he mentioned all the good deeds of Sayyidina Umar, the good achievements.
ماذا قال عمر؟
What did Umar رضي الله عنه reply to سيدنا ابن عباس؟
لعل ذلك على شرط لم يقع.
He said maybe all of that was on a condition that I did not fulfill.
هذا هو الذي عليه أن يكون عليه.
So this is how a Muslim is supposed to be.
المسلم أن يعمل كل شيء.
A Muslim must do everything he can do, the good deeds.
ويخاف ولا يقبل منه.
But after that he must still fear, maybe Allah has not accepted any of that. May Allah accept from you and us all the good deeds. For the sake of the honor of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.